Can you turn poop into nanites? That may not be the first question you have when it comes to No Man's Sky, but that hasn't stopped people from posting that you can, so let's examine this fecal claim. First, let's point out that there are quite a few places this has been mentioned, and usually with an over-the-top claim such as
30,000 nanites in 10 minutes.
But that's just a way to get your attention, so don't get your hopes up yet. The whole idea is really to do with faecium, which you can get by collecting poop. Though I'm pretty sure that's not how you want to spend your time in No Man's Sky. It's not just faecium though, but rather a multi-step process to refine it into an item that can be traded for nanites. That's right, we will be refining poop. You can collect faecium from animal poop by tossing out some creature pellets and then following the creatures around with a little bag. But that's not the only way. You can also plant and harvest gut rot flowers, which will give you 39 faecium per plant each time. There is, of course, a waiting delay since you have to let the plants regrow each time, but hey, it's better than picking up poop for an hour. Once you have a bunch of faecium, the next step is to refine it into mordite in one of your refiners. It only takes one slot, so you can use any of the refiners to do this. Note, however, that the refinement process is a 3-to-2 ratio, so for every 3 faecium, you will get back 2 mordite. Once you have refined into mordite, you now want to head to the nutrient processor. Here you will put in the mordite and refine it into meat flakes at a 1-to-1 ratio for up to 50 at a time.
Meat flakes. Just like Mama used to make.
As appetizing as the meat flakes may be, once they are done, you want to refine them as well into meaty chunks. Man, meaty chunks. Are you salivating yet? Okay, jokes aside, you'll get a stack of 50 meaty chunks from each nutrient processor cycle. Now, this is where some people may get confused, because if you place a single stack of meaty chunks in the nutrient processor, you will create processed meat. What you need to do instead is place 2 stacks of meaty chunks in the nutrient processor, which will cause it to produce mystery meat stew. Why do 2 stacks of the same item produce a different end product? I don't know. Ask the devs why they went with that recipe. Anyway, the 2 stacks will produce a single matching size stack of mystery meat stew, so 2 stacks of 50 meat chunks will get you 1 stack of 50 meat stew. Now for the final part. After you have racked up however many stacks of mystery meat stew you care to have on your person, head to the anomaly. Go and find Iteration Cronus in the upper right area. He is the resident food connoisseur and will gladly judge your mystery meat stew. Don't worry, because every stew is a winner here. There are 3 levels of nanite payouts you will get here. The most common responses will get you 40 nanites each time. The less common and better responses will get you 70 nanites each time, while the most rare and highest praise responses will get you 129 nanites. So there you go. You can technically turn poop into nanites through a bunch of intermediary steps. But I'm sure some people are asking now, how effective is this? First, I want to point out you can skip some steps and just plant mordite root. This is a point where there will be a lot of argument over gut rot flowers versus mordite root. Gut rot has a 4-hour growth cycle, while mordite has an 8-hour cycle. Mordite root will net you more mordite per harvest than gut rot flowers and refining will, though. In my opinion, it comes down to how often each day you can do this, and more importantly, want to do this. If it's more than 4 but less than 8 hours between each game session, go with gut rot flowers. Otherwise, go with mordite root, as you won't be harvesting often enough to get any benefit from gut rot flowers' shorter cycle time. Next, there is of course the refinement time. You have multiple stages to refine through, and that will add a bit of time. Not much overall, because it really comes down to the final trading process. You can only trade 1 mystery meat stew at a time, and Cronus has this little animation he goes through on some of the responses that slows things down a bit. In my testing, I was getting around 5-6 seconds per trade. Overall, it took about 40 minutes to harvest the mordite root, do all the processing, and trade 200 mystery meat stew to Cronus to get a total of 12,344 nanites. This breaks down to an average of 61.72 nanites per meat stew. So do I think this is now the best way to farm nanites in the game? Well, not really. It is a very good way to get nanites, especially without having to have a money farm already in place, but this is a very boring method as well. Honestly, this was probably the most boring moment I've had in playing the game, so I'm sure this is not the first thing someone will want to do each time they play. I personally still prefer buying and scrapping ships, as I outlined in my previous nanite farming video. This is due to looking at different ships keeps it varied, as well as getting storage upgrades from scrapping them. The storage upgrades are useful for expanding the storage space of the ships you keep, such as maybe that new exotic you found after watching my recent video on how to find exotic ships. You won't get those upgrades with the Fecium method. In the end though, use any method you like. Farm some gut rot or mordite root while you are busy with other things, and then do a long haul session of processing and trading. Between those sessions, you can also scrap starships for even more nanites, and that's how you will really get the 30k nanites an hour that so many videos clickbait you with. Now, leave a comment and share how many calories you think Cronus consumed with 200 mystery meat stew, and how did he not explode after eating so much? And be sure to check out some of my other No Man's Sky content and hit subscribe so you can keep up in the future.